Okay, let's move to the next function, which is named as distribution management. So before we move into the different matrices, let's understand what is distribution management. So distribution management refers to a process of overseeing the movement of goods from suppliers or manufacturers to the point of sales. And it includes multiple activities and processes like packaging, warehousing, and also logistics into the picture. So our first matrix is distribution expense. So we know that all organization expenses vary with different requirements of the firm. Similarly, distribution expense also varies based on the number of shipments that are received or number of shipments that are sent to the customer. So that is why distribution expense can be calculated in two different ways. The first is distribution expense for inbound shipments, and second is distribution expense for outbound shipments. It is better to take cost of goods sold value to relate with and to understand the performance of distribution expense out of total expense that organization is doing. And it gives a justification on cost variations, if any, and it also provides shipment-wise cost or unit-wise cost if taken in a more detailed distribution expense. And this calculation of distribution expense is like distribution expense divided by cost of goods sold. So it will give you the percentage of distribution expense into the cost of goods sold. And that's why we can also understand how this percentage is varied month on month or with different periods. So let's take a simple example. Consider the cost of goods sold for the month of May. It was $5,000. And distribution expense in that month was $500, which means simply 10% of cost of goods sold is a distribution expense. However, if we move to the month of June, we have seen the cost of goods sold of around $4,000 and distribution expense of around $480, which means 12% is the distribution expense. And it simply tells us an opportunity for understanding why expense in the month of June was higher as compared to total cost of goods sold. And hence, we can understand areas for controlling the cost factor. In an ideal situation, distribution expense has to be low to show the better performance of the organization. Our next metric is warehouse capacity used. So we all know that warehouses or store space is a crunch in many organizations, and the capacity available may not be sufficient to support manufacturing activities. But if business wants to grow, cost reduction focus should be more aggressive and warehouse space utilized, which turns into cost for rent, cost for labor, electricity, material handling equipments, also scrap and obsolescence. This indicator gives idea of how effectively warehouse space is utilized, and it can give more action plans for improvement in terms of reducing inventory or also changing the store's layout as an action point. The indicator is measured in percentage as the ratio of warehouse space used, which is either in square feet or any other unit, divided by total warehouse space in the similar units. In an ideal situation, higher the capacity of warehouse used, it is better for the planning and better the resources are utilized. Our next metric is material handling damage, and this indicator basically defines material handling performance of manufacturing firm. This gives action on improvement like setting or redesigning material handling processes or equipments which are used to handle the materials, or it also helps to give a special attention to be taken in the processes of material handling. This indicator is calculated as taking cost of materials damaged in handling and divided by total cost of goods sold. So we are again relating that total damage with the cost of goods sold. And that's why this indicator is giving an opportunity to understand a relation of, you know, incurred cost. In an ideal situation, lower the damage, better the performance for the organization. Our next metric is undamaged supplier shipment rate. So this is basically ratio of total number of shipments that are received from supplier without damaged condition to the total number of shipments which are received in a particular time period. The ratio also provides overview on performance of supplier in terms of quality, but on other side, this also supports performance of logistics or freight forwarder in terms of material handling if this is damaged which has happened in the transit. Hence, undamaged supplier rate is equal to number of shipments received from supplier without damage condition divided by total number of shipments received from supplier into 100, because it is into percentage. This ratio also provided some overview on performance of supplier in terms of quality. And in an ideal situation, supply chain is seeking to have lower damaged shipments and better the quality of supplier and also better the quality of freight forwarders. So this was all about the key performance matrices. We hope that you have enjoyed this course.